Joining me now from Limpopo province are two choristers. We have Sandile and Lungelo. Hi, guys.
Hi.
Let's just get your self-introductions. What is your full name? How old are you? And how long have you been with the choir?
Well, I'll start. I know it's ladies first, but I'll start. Yeah, I'm Sandile Majola, and I'm 26 years of age. I've been with the choir since 2009, before it became professional.
I am Lungelo Masano. I've been with the choir since 2015. I think it's been 6 years. Yeah.
All right, so let's watch a little bit of We Will Rise, and then we'll come back and talk about it some more. Okay, now this is a beautiful music video, very inspiring, but it's just one of many videos that you guys have put out. So how is this one different than all of the other visual performances you've done?
This one is different because it came out on a very difficult time, as we are all facing this pandemic right now. And the message that we wanted to send out was that we will rise above whatever that we're facing right now.
What about all the costuming? You've got a clown in there, you have showgirls, you have all kinds of different costumes. What's going on there?
We were displaying the different kind of people in the entertainment industry.
Yeah.
So we wanted people to understand that we're talking about the entertainment industry as a whole, not just choir, the people who sing,
yeah.
The people who dance too, and do theater shows, stuff like
chefs, crew members, everyone has their work on hold during this pandemic and couldn't do what they love.
I read too that when you started, Sandile, you had no musical experience or background whatsoever. Is that true?
No musical experience whatsoever. Didn't even know how to play those drums, nothing.
So how did you get into the choir? How did you get into the choir?
I had the voice that I could sing, but it still needed some training, and
right.
I still needed a lot of training.
I notice you're performing in an auditorium that has empty seats in the background. At one point in the middle, the curtains open, and you know, it's empty.
It really is empty, and that's the life right now.
Yeah.
How has the choir shaped your lives?
It has shaped our lives in different ways. It has given us all voices. It has hope, dreams. It has given us a space to dream and to feel that if you can dream it, you can be it, you can do it. The stages that we've been, the people that we always look up to, we are now working with them. We are now amongst the greatest people that we've always seen on TV.
What's up next? What are you guys planning? I'm sure you're all waiting for your vaccines to come in there and have an effect. Hopefully 2021 will bring us some relief. Are you already planning for what you're going to do when you can actually have wings again and fly?
Doing shows, we are owing a lot of people a lot of shows, and so this pandemic has just hit us so bad that we had a lot planned, and we're just gonna take it from where we left, and we just cannot wait. We're tired of performing for cameras.
We're tired of performing for empty chairs and stuff like that. We're not.
Yeah, so we miss people.
We miss people.
You know, exchanging energies.
Yeah.
Thank you so much.